There have always been great thinkers and inventors who have brought mankind forward. Every schoolchild knows their names. From Galileo to Einstein, progress would have been inconceivable without them. The subject matter has become more diverse and complex in today's globalized world, but there are still many great inventors. The last two centuries have been dominated by industrialization and steady technological progress, and our Earth pays the price. The raw materials which fuel this industrial progress are becoming increasingly scarce. Mankind is slowly coming to terms with the fact that we need to find more sustainable resources. Despite the ubiquity of plastic and synthetic materials, natural resources are currently experiencing a rebirth. One of the oldest natural products used by man, cork, catches the attention of two scientists from Portugal. Who doesn't love that wonderful sound? An absolute necessity for wine connoisseurs, the real natural cork. But for how long will this rare product continue to exist? The natural resources are limited, while global demand is rising. Because cork doesn't only let wine breathe, the bark of the cork oak is an ideal insulating material. The small country of Portugal is the largest global exporter. The Alentejo region is famous for its cork oak woods. For more than 20 years, the scientists Helena Pereira and Antonio Velez have been studying one of Portugal's national treasures.
Cork protects the trees. It is waterproof, isolating, and has very specific properties which stem from its chemical cell structure. And additionally, this tree has the ability to produce new cork by itself as soon as the cork is harvested.
The problem: the oak has to grow for 25 years before the cork can be harvested for the first time. From this point on, the outer bark can only be taken off every 9 years. The only solution: you have to make the cork bigger than it is. If you increase its volume, the same amount of cork can be used to manufacture more products. For decades, the two researchers studied how cork reacts to various natural substances. Antonio Velez demonstrates their ingenious invention by means of a simple experiment. The cork is soaked and cooked in an industrial pressure cooker. If you irradiate the wet cork with microwaves afterwards, an amazing result is achieved. The effect caused by the microwaves doesn't impact the cork, but the water. The water molecules heat up, causing the pressure within the cork cells to increase through the heat. This makes the cork cells expand and the volume rises. With this new process, the volume can be increased by 40 to 85%. While the cork retains its natural characteristics.
Cork is already being used to great success in the isolating system of the space shuttle. In the future, it could be used for absorbing oil slicks or other substances harmful to nature.
Since the beginning, man uses the resources of nature to produce energy. From wind to water power, the German Museum in Munich has one of the largest collections in renewable energy over the past centuries. With the emergence of fossil fuels, they first lost some of their relevance. Brought on by environmental degradation, we see a comeback of sustainable energy in recent decades. In Germany, the potential of photovoltaic was recognized early on. Based in Freiburg, Adolf Gutzenberger founded the Fraunhofer Institute for Solar Technology some 40 years ago. In 2009, he was awarded the European Inventor Award in the category of lifetime achievement, but research continues. The goal is to improve energy efficiency and production processes. At the center is a dedicated physicist in Germany. The sun. Without it, life would not be possible. It makes us feel good, warms us up, and provides an infinite amount of energy. Long considered too expensive and inefficient, solar power is now an integral part of our energy supply. For making photovoltaic affordable to everyone, as well as for some of the most important research into this technology, we can thank this man, Dr. Jörg Hortzel. Quite early, it was clear to me that renewable energy could play a critical role in actively protecting against climate change. Photovoltaic, in particular, has considerable potential because the sun provides many times more energy than is required. But what is the best way to harness the natural power of the sun? To find out, in 1994, this German physicist began his search for partners who shared his vision. He found them in Belgium, the Inter-University Microelectronics Center, EMEC, one of the largest research institutes in the world. To manufacture solar cells, phosphorus is melted into a silicon layer, which experts refer to as doping. This process creates the conditions for the conversion of sunlight into energy. Jörg Hortzel has sped up and perfected this very time-consuming process that once had to be carried out in several steps. This is made possible by solar cells with selectively doped regions. We have invented a selective emitter process, which in a single step forms lightly doped and heavily doped areas next to each other. Since the process can be performed in one step, the process costs can be reduced and the efficiency can be increased. Globalization may be bringing the world closer together, but people are also becoming more diverse and more mobile. In many cities, traffic is at a standstill. The pressure on the environment is enormous. In addition to the search for more environmentally friendly engines for the classic automobile, the search is on for an alternative to air travel in the form of high-speed trains. The Austrian Kurt Theurer, with approximately 600 patents under his belt, is certainly one of the most active researchers in this field. Thanks to his inventions, the rails are ready for fast trains. A Spanish engineer is taking care of the suspensions. This train is traveling at 350 kilometers per hour. Most passengers, however, don't notice a thing. They're reading or sleeping quietly. And when the train enters a curve, the event goes completely unnoticed. The man who makes this possible, Spaniard José Luis López Gómez. He has developed a technology that makes traveling by high-speed train faster, more comfortable, and safer. For that, he receives the European Inventor Award. This engineer has made it possible for passengers to drink their coffee in peace and without fear that the next corner could send the coffee flying. This is the crux of the Gómez idea. Instead of rotating on an axle, each wheel rotates independently. A computer system constantly monitors and corrects the wheel position. Gómez's invention amounts to a completely new type of wheel control. Employing this system, we're able to move the wheel bearing so that the bar rests in the middle of the wheel. If at one point or another there is a decentering, the wheel bearing control realigns with the center. With his research, Gómez has enhanced a modern train technology with several important inventions. However, he's particularly proud of the wheel location optimization. I believe that the speed of trains is always dependent on the technology that is currently available. With this patented system, it will be possible for the speed to reach 400, 450 kilometers per hour, and beyond that. To provide a platform for the inventors of today and publicly highlight their achievements, the European Patent Office launched the European Inventor Award 7 years ago. This year, the coveted trophies were awarded in Amsterdam. Patents are very important to the competitiveness of the European economy, as they are the best way to protect innovation and assure the technological development of products. The world has become faster, and life is increasingly chaotic, but we humans are still the same. Can our bodies even cope with so much pressure and so many external influences? Health is one of the central issues of our time.
Traditionally, in the European Inventor Award, we have a strong emphasis on the field of healthcare, because what people are interested about is what is affecting them directly in their daily lives.
The figures are alarming. Throughout the world, more and more people are suffering from cancer. According to experts, there will be more than 22 million new cases until the year 2030. The invention of the scanning tunneling microscope in 1981, beside other technological innovations in the field of medicine, opens up a whole world for scientists. It's the birth of nanotechnology. It's a cosmos on the scale of nanometers, billionths of a meter, rich in complex structures. On these are the secrets of life. A special discovery in the realm of the tiny comes from France, nanocapsules which are employed in the fight against cancer. They protect us from UV rays and help prevent sweating. With them, our cars stay clean longer and footballs are more resistant to abrasion. Tiny nanoparticles play a huge role in our daily lives. Nanotechnology is, however, also employed in the medical field, for example, to treat cancer. Invisible nanocapsules transport medication directly to infected tissues in the body. It is a revolution in cancer therapy. Patrick Couvreur is a revolutionary. Born in Belgium, the French scientist has won the European Inventor Award for his breakthrough in administering cancer medication. This is his reward for so many years of research. I'm not only a researcher, but a pharmacist as well. For this reason, it has always been my dream to help create a new type of medication which can treat deadly diseases, such as cancer. Couvreur fought for this miracle pill for over 30 years before he was able to start producing it. He has managed to program the nanocapsules. In his lab at the Université Paris-Sud, the capsules are made in such a way that they bring medication in concentrated form directly to the affected tissue. This helps mitigate side effects. Normally, when a drug is administered, it is distributed throughout the entire body. This causes side effects, which may lead to symptoms of poisoning, together with reduced efficacy of the drug. Couvreur's idea was to create an intelligent transport mechanism for cancer drugs. We target the tumor using a coat of polymers that reacts to the environment, so we can control the release of the drug precisely, thus significantly improving the success of the treatment. The invention of another Belgian could save the lives of thousands in the future. Many cancer patients have high hopes for the proton therapy, an improved form of the irradiation. The advantage? It's much safer than commonly used radiation therapy. Here we can see treatment of a tumor with X-rays. They damage the brain as well as the tumor, and the damage is irreparable. If I irradiate the tumor with just protons, the brain is spared the radiation, and this is much better. Here's how proton therapy works. The proton beams are fired at the patient's body at a speed of 200,000 kilometers per second. With magnets, they can be steered accurately, targeting and destroying tumors in deep tissue by damaging the DNA of tumor cells. In Yves Jongen's proton therapy centers, more than 20,000 patients have been treated. But for Jongen, every single individual counts. When I even go to a treatment center and see patients being treated, it makes me happy. And I'm particularly moved when children are treated with this technology. However, researchers are not content with the mere improvement of existing therapies. They have instead been working on revolutionary methods made possible by the decoding of the human genome. The door to so-called personalized medicine is now open. The quick, inexpensive identification of defects in DNA and the potential of targeted therapy is all made possible by an invention of a biologist from Sweden. Physicians have long dreamed of being able to treat cancer using custom treatments. For example, they could replace diseased cells with healthy DNA material from a patient. This is a vision that may soon become reality. This man has created a breakthrough technology that helps sequence the DNA in cells quickly and cheaply. This is Paul Nurein from Sweden. This method, which is referred to as pyrosequencing, means that you decipher the genetic code and then use it to solve various problems. This method is mainly used to analyze various diseases, such as cancer. Before the invention of pyrosequencing, decrypting the genetic code of a person took 13 years and cost around 75 million euros. Now, thanks to Nirin's idea, the process runs automatically. For just 6,000 euros, the entire sequence of a cell can be read in just 2 months. Nurein's quick and inexpensive DNA analysis now makes it possible for cancer researchers to develop therapies tailored to each individual patient. Here's how Nurein's DNA decryption process works. Our genetic information is laid out like a ladder. To find out how it is arranged, Nurein cut the ladder in half lengthwise and then put the two halves back together again, rung by rung. The scientists then add the four base units and phosphorus to a container. One after the other, the apparatus samples through all the building blocks. When there's a hit, the phosphorus produces a flash. A computer registers the light and records the appropriate block. It's really great to develop something and believe that it has a real use. It's really special to be able to help people or others in their research. But not only inventions that improve health will be presented with a European Inventor Award. All inventions which are of great benefit to the community and create jobs and wealth are welcome.
It took some time for the European Inventor Award to get recognition in industry, but we are now well established and industries well respecting this award and they consider it as the most important award in technical innovation.
One invention has transformed the living rooms of this world in recent years. Flat screens may be built in South Korea or Great Britain, but they were invented by a man from Switzerland. If you're looking for a television nowadays, you simply cannot avoid this technology, LCD. It dominates the market. LCD technology is not just found in TV sets, but everywhere. It's in tablets, smartphones, and many other display systems. As the inventor of LCD technology, Martin Schad from Switzerland has made all these possible. This is how it works. An LCD is composed of a layer of liquid crystals, which are lit up from behind. Using varying electrical voltage, the crystals can either transmit light or not. In this way, you can create an image on the display. Martin Schad then developed a prototype. He guards it like a treasure, because this unit serves as the basis for today's LCD technology. What you see here is a primitive prototype. This was a first rotating cell display, and at the time, I never imagined that this would become such a huge international success. There was a mountain of technical and scientific problems that needed to be resolved first. Schad solved them all. The Swiss invention has developed into a huge market. In 2012, 90 billion euros were spent on devices using LCD technology. While millions of people have profited from this groundbreaking technology, the inventor himself has also benefited personally. As you get older, your vision gets worse, and I tried to decide whether to buy a new pair of glasses or a new monitor. I went with a monitor. Fantastic. An invention like no other helped to define the 20th century, the computer. It all started 80 years ago with these two giants, the Z3 and the Z4. This is how the first mainframes looked. In the 1970s, the first computer for home use was launched. Now the dominance of the personal computer is simply overwhelming. Computers are becoming smaller and more powerful, thanks to the invention of a lady from the UK. It's found in smartphones, in video and digital cameras, as well as in tablet PCs. It even saves lives, powering the ABS in your car. We're talking about the ARM RISC processor, a tiny chip that breathes life into mobile devices. For her invention, Sophie Wilson has been nominated for the European Inventor Award in the category Lifetime Achievement. The secret to Wilson's chip: it requires very little energy, no cooling, and it is so small that it fits in smartphones and tablets. It is special because it has so few transistors. These switch and manage the electrical signals. This makes the ARM processor a true computing wonder. Sophie Wilson developed the chip for the company ARM in exactly 18 months. Today, this tiny processor remains a huge seller. Lots of manufacturers use them in their devices.
On the wall, we have a picture of ARM 1, 7 millimeters on a side, 25,000 transistors. And here we have, drawn to exactly the same scale, a picture of a modern version of the same capability ARM processor. It's 70 micron on a side, which makes it about 10,000 times smaller.
For a long time, many inventions have started in the field of mechanics. Now this expands to include microelectronics and nanotechnology. But sometimes the small, almost mundane things that change our daily lives are the ones that have the greatest impact. For a team of quirky engineers from Austria, it was just a bit too loud at home. Listen for yourself. Oh, what a kitchen has to endure every day. Doors and drawers are slammed shut. A stress test for man and kitchen alike. But it doesn't have to be that way. The reason for the silence: a tiny invisible invention that is worth millions. Shock absorbers for cabinet doors. In the kitchen, there's always lots of commotion. When you're working there, you notice there is lots going on, a lot of moving around. And the need to harmonize this motion and to quieten things down was rather obvious. The underlying technology is an engineering masterpiece. A piston absorbs the shock of closing doors and sinks into a chamber with hydraulic fluid. The plunger slowly depresses, thus minimizing the impact and ensuring that doors close quietly. Meanwhile, the inventor's company has an annual turnover of over 1 billion euros. All thanks, among others, to one little stick. When the team patented the invention in 2001, no one imagined that it would become such a huge international hit. We're very proud that our invention is being used all over the world. This one here might end up in a kitchen in Brazil. Whether it's everyday technology that makes our lives easier or high-tech medical research that saves lives, every one of the nominees and winners of the European Inventor Award 2013 have helped humanity move one more step forward.
Our intention when launching the European Inventor Award was to bridge the gap between a patent and the invention, which profits to people in their daily lives. Once we have managed to dig out the real patents behind these innovations, we can also identify the people behind the innovations, and then we can tell a story about them.
Whether or not you'll be able to marvel at today's inventors in the textbooks of the future, where each child knows their names, remains to be seen in the next 100 years. One thing is for sure: human beings will always go on inventing.